Hi, this is a video in response to the handler of the name Judeo-Christian Church on YouTube. So you can just search for him if you want. I'm responding to him because he's so wrong in everything he says, and I just found it disturbing, so I had to correct him. The title of his post is "The Truth About September 2015, Why It Will Not or Did Not Bring the Rapture." A lot of us are not claiming that it's going to bring the rapture, so that's not an argument. What's happening is it's the conclusion of the tetrads. It's the eighth one since Christ, and it's indicating the soon return of the Lord. The sixth one occurred when Israel became a nation. The seventh was when Israel took over Jerusalem, and the eighth has to do with the rebuilding of the third temple, and that has to be completed very carefully, like Daniel 8:14 says. It has to be completed so that by the time it's completed, there are 2300 days left for it to be cleansed. So there are 2300 days always from Passover to Tisha B'Av. Tisha B'Av was when the first and second temples were destroyed. So from Passover in 2023 to Tisha B'Av 2029. That's your 2300 days right there. It's not 2016 to 2022 because the third temple won't be completed in time, obviously, right? So that's pretty simple to understand. So what's happening is God's judging. He's giving us 7 years of plenty, then followed by 7 years of famine. And the Bible says store up for 7 years of plenty because you know that 7 years of famine is coming. The 7 years of famine is 2022 to 2029. What is the sign of the Son of Man in Matthew 24, verses 30? It is, I can't think of anything better than asteroid Apophis in 2029, April 13th, 2029. So that'll be the year that Jesus returns in the sign of the Son of Man. This asteroid Apophis is 3 football fields in length. It comes within 25,000 miles of Earth, within satellite distance range. And the last time it hit Earth was about, this size hit Earth was about 80,000 years ago. So it happened quite a long time ago, and it's extremely rare. And if it were to hit Earth, it would kill tens of millions of people today. So I just want to start off by saying that about his comments is that the very name of his handle for his YouTube is Judeo-Christian Church. This is an improper usage of the term church. Never do you see that term used in the Bible for church. It would be like saying the Russian Christian Church or the Black People Christian Church or the Asian Christian Church. None of those are acceptable. The church in the Bible is defined as a locality always, either as the universal church or as a locality. So it is correct to say the church of Jerusalem in the churches of Judea, but never is it nationally ever considered the church in the Bible. It would be correct to say you belong to the church of Dallas in the churches of Texas, but it would not be correct to say the Southern Baptist White People Church or the Presbyterian Church, but it would be acceptable to say the church the church in Antioch in the churches of Syria. I just want to get that point out of the way. I already know he's confused right off the bat because he doesn't get the church right. And now his issue is prophecy is only for looking back to confirm or as a point of recognition that something is true. But that's not true. That's true in that, yes, you can use it for that purpose, but it's also true that it tells you of things that are going to happen in the future before they have happened, and that gives you comfort. So prophecy is for both preparation and recognition. And don't believe otherwise. For example, prepare for 7 years of plenty in 2015 to 2022 before the 7 years of famine in 22 to 2029. Zechariah was on his side for 390 days to predict when Israel would become a nation again, May 1948. That is, to me, the most amazing prophecy of all. There's Daniel's prophecy. He predicted when the Messiah would literally be cut off to the day. It's unbelievable. Next, I wanted to say that, okay, he has an issue with the rapture before the tribulation. But this is logical to say because someone predicted wrongly the date of the first rapture, that therefore the first rapture must be false. That doesn't make any sense at all. I'm personally comforted knowing the first rapture, according to Readiness, is September 26th, Feast of Trumpets, 2015. And the verses that support that there's a first rapture, not just a first rapture, but a first rapture according to Readiness. So not all Christians will be raptured on the first rapture. Just those who kept the word of his patience, were watchful and prayerful. And that's supported by the conditional statements in Matthew 24, verses 40 to 42, Luke 21, 36, and Revelation 3:10. Now, this speaker, he also goes so far to say that Satan is telling people that they'll be raptured September 26, you know, if they fulfill the condition for the first rapture on Feast of Trumpets in 2050. But we're not saying that's when the rapture is going to take place. Sorry, I got September 26th, Feast of Trumpets, 2022. September 14th, 2015 would be the other date for the rapture. But it's not going to take place then, because what you're experiencing there is that there's going to be 7 years of plenty. Now, something's going to happen on September 13th, Elul 29. Just like it did in the 7 years prior to that, and then the 7 years prior to that. So something's going to happen. The markets will drop 7%. Big deal. It's not a big deal. It's only part of the greater event that's occurring. Like in 2008, it was a housing crisis. And 2000, and in 2001, things were just insanely overvalued. So they had to collapse at that point. What else did I want to say? He's speaking in terms of all or nothing. All as you read the Bible and prepare for the Lord, or nothing. You can't know when the Lord returns and when the rapture is. But we actually do know, well, we should know when the Lord returns and when the rapture is. Because Revelation 3:3 says, If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and you shall not know when or what hour I will come upon thee. So if you're not watchful, you won't know when the Lord comes. So you need to be watchful, and then you can know when the Lord returns. I want to finish off by saying this. This speaker, he's being self-righteous and arrogant. He says there will be so much. This is what was really weird. He said there will be so much evidence of end times that most people will be deceived. That doesn't make any sense either. If there was such massive evidence, then most people would not be deceived. The fact is, the evidence will not be gangbusters, but nonetheless, it will be sufficient enough that people will be guilty for not accepting it. That's everything I have to say, so that's it. Thanks, bye.